the blood. Would you live daily his praises to sing? There's wonderful power in the blood. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. What can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is that flow that makes me white as snow. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. For my cleansing this I see. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. For my pardon this my plea. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is that flow that makes me white as snow. No other fount I know. Nothing but blood of Jesus. Nothing can for sin atone. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Not of good that I have done. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is that flow that makes me white as snow. No other fount I know. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Now by this I'll overcome. Now by this I'll overcome. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Now by this I'll reach my home. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is that flow that makes me white as snow. No other fount I know. Nothing but glory, glory. Amen, I sing. Glory, glory, this I sing. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. All my praise for this I bring. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is that flow that makes me white as snow. No other fount I know. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Amen. It's by his blood I've been healed, and by your prayers. I appreciate you all. Amen. Brother Mark will come. He abides this evening. Y'all may be seated. Hey, we appreciate our streamers, right? Let's give our streamers a hand and just bless them, Lord. Let the word go to them, amen. Appreciate the means to give it out to them. I'm rejoicing night and day as I walk the pilgrim way, for the hand of God in all my life I see. And the reason of the bliss, yes, the secret all is this, that the Comforter abides in me. He abides, he abides, hallelujah, he abides in me. I'm rejoicing night and day as I walk the narrow way, for the Comforter abides in me. Once my heart was full of sin, once I had no peace within, till I heard how Jesus died upon a tree. Then I fell down at his feet, and there came a peace so sweet. Soon the Comforter abides in me. He abides, he abides, hallelujah, he abides in me. I'm rejoicing night and day as I walk the narrow way, for the Comforter abides in me. He is with me everywhere, and he knows my every care. I'm as happy as a bird, just as free. For the Spirit has control, satisfies my soul, since a Comforter abides in me. Oh, he abides, he abides, hallelujah, he abides in me. When rejoicing night and day, as I go the narrow way, for the Comforter abides in me. There's no thirsting of the things of the world, they've taken wings. Help, no, I gave them up and instantly. All my night was turned to day, all my burdens rolled away. Now the Comforter abides in me. He abides, he abides, hallelujah, he abides in me. I'm rejoicing night and day as I walk the narrow way. Comforter abides in me. It's good to see you as a deer panteth this evening. Amen. As a deer panteth for the water, so my soul longeth after thee. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee. Let's all stand. For you strength and shield, to you alone does my spirit yield. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee. You are my friend, and you are my brother, even though my King. I want you more than any other, so much more than anything. For you alone are my strength and shield, to you alone does my spirit yield. Desire, and I long to worship thee. Listen to this. I want you more than gold or silver, only you can satisfy. You alone. joy giver and the apple of my eye. For you alone are my strength, my shield. To you alone does my spirit yield. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee. Hosanna, blessed be the rock, blessed be the rock of my salvation. Hosanna, blessed be the rock, blessed be the rock of my salvation. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, for he is worthy to be praised. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, for he is worthy to be praised. Hosanna, blessed be the rock, blessed be the rock of my salvation. Hosanna, blessed be the rock, blessed. Let the ladies sing glory, glory, man. Ladies, glory, glory, glory. Amen, glory. He lives forevermore. Glory, glory to his name. Lives and reigns forevermore. Lift your hands. Hosanna, blessed be the rock, blessed be the rock of my salvation. Hosanna, blessed be rock, blessed be the rock. All right, man, let's sing it out, man. Brother Dale comes. Jehovah is his name, for he provideth all my needs. Jehovah Jireh is his name, for he provideth all my needs. Raise your hands. Hosanna, Lord, blessed be the rock of my salvation. Hosanna, blessed be the rock of my salvation.
Amen, amen, and amen. He's the rock of our salvation, isn't he? Amen. Good to see everybody in the house of the Lord. You ready for the word?
Amen.
Getting ready to hear our brother as he ministers unto us. Remember, Wait in June will be gone Sunday. So remember that. To pray the Lord would bless. Brother Luis is. Got brother, do some more talking for somebody else. We're going to have to teach these people how to speak English. Right. Yeah, okay. That way, he at least gets a double part. He can interpret and he can preach it. So he can say, now this is what I meant to say when I just read this over here, you know. So it'll all work out. But just thank you, God, for the voice of people to be able to do these things to where they can do it. Amen. All right, let's just sing Open the Eyes of My Heart as Brother Lan Lan comes to minister the word of the Lord unto us this day. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. The eyes of my heart, I want to see you. I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart, I want to see. I want to see you, to see you high and lifted up. Shine.
shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing, holy, holy, holy. High and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing, holy, holy, holy. Holy, 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 you are holy, holy, holy. Holy, 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 I want to see.
Praise the Lord. God bless you, saints. I bring greetings in the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And I'm happy to be with you this evening.
Amen.
And I'm so grateful and thankful to God for giving me once again this opportunity to come and fellowship with you, brothers and sisters.
Amen.
And just bear with me with my broken English. And just pray for me that God will help me this evening. So while we are we remain standing, let us bow our heads and let us approach, hallelujah, the author of this word. Father God, once again, we are so thankful, Lord God, for this another opportunity that you have given us to come together into this house and fellowship together, and above all, to hear your eternal word. Father God, as we are going to open our Bibles, I pray, Father God, that you will send down the Holy Spirit and you will bless us and anoint us. Lord God, we can do nothing by ourselves, Lord. You know, Lord God, hallelujah, how limited is my ability to speak English. And as your word, the Bible says that all scripture is given by inspiration,
Amen.
Is written, hallelujah, by the inspiration of the Holy Spirit. And Lord, our carnal mind cannot comprehend it, Lord. We need, Lord God, the Holy Spirit to come and help us, teach us, Lord God. Hallelujah. And Lord, I pray that you will anoint your word, anoint the servant, Lord God. Hallelujah. Circumcise my lips, my mind, and my heart, and be it used, Lord God, for your glory and for your honor. Bless also and anoint every ear, Lord God, this evening. Oh, in the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Praise the Lord. And as we remain standing, let us open up our Bible in the book of Romans, chapter 15. From verse 1 up to verse 4, it says here, "We then that are strong ought to bear the infirmities of the weak, and not to please ourselves. Let every one of us please his neighbor for his good edification. For even Christ pleased not himself, but as it is written, the reproach of them that reproach thee fell on me." Verse 4, "For whatsoever things were written aforetime were written for our learning, that we through patience and comfort of the scriptures might have hope." And one more verse in 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 5. "Ye also as lively stones are built up a spiritual house and household and holy priesthood to offer up spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God by Jesus Christ."
Amen.
May the Lord add blessing upon the reading of his word, and you may be seated in the presence of the Lord. And I would like also to thanks our beloved pastor, Pastor Samuel Dale, and his family, Brother Wade, for accommodating me and for allowing me to having a trust to stand behind this pulpit.
Yeah.
And also for the beautiful hotel room. Hallelujah. And may the Lord will reward you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And if anything that I can say that is not again that is not in line what your pastor is teaching, just forget it. And I hope and I trust that tonight the Lord will help us, and I just want to be a blessing.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So I don't want to bring deep things, but I just want to share simple things that would be a blessing and encouragement to every one of us.
Amen.
So this evening I would like to talk about the subject about the royal priesthood.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Now, it says here, we then that are strong ought to bear the infirmities of the weak, and not to please ourselves. Let every one of us please his neighbor as his good, for his good edification. Then we have the example, for even Christ pleased not himself, but as it is written, the reproaches of them that reproach thee fell on me. Hallelujah. And in the book of Revelation, chapter 5, verse 10, he says, and he has made us kings and priests.
Right.
Hallelujah. And we shall reign on earth, on the earth. So, and there are some other scripture that Peter had written. He says, we are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Now, when we see the priests in the Old Testament, they are people who live with a consecrated and dedicated lives to God.
Yeah, right.
Hallelujah. And they do not live for their own selves, but they live to serve, hallelujah, their brethren.
Amen.
Amen. And they didn't even have a portion on the land. Hallelujah. But yet, God took care of them, for them.
Yeah,
hallelujah, for God is their portion.
Amen.
Hallelujah. They are the people, hallelujah, who don't care so much about material things.
Right.
But they are more on the spiritual side.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Right.
And they are more spiritual than other, although Israelites are being called the people of God.
Sure.
But when it comes to spiritual level, they are more in a higher level.
Right,
hallelujah.
Yeah, sure.
So, natural Israel is tied to the natural Israel, which is the church. And the Bible says that God he has made us kings and priests.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Okay.
Now, Abraham said in their journey, Israel's journey from Egypt going to the promised land, hallelujah, Abraham said that many people refer the promised land to the millennium.
Yep.
It is not.
No.
Hallelujah. The promised land had wars and killings.
Right.
Millennium won't have any wars or killing.
Right.
It referred to the Holy Spirit,
right,
the battleground.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So, means that God had a promise to the children of Abraham,
right,
which is a natural land.
Right.
But our promise is our lives in the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
As Peter said that for the promise is unto you and unto your children and to children and children unto the other. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As many as, hallelujah, He is going to call.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, once we became the part of that body, the body of the Lord Jesus Christ, hallelujah, we are baptized, and to be part of that body is not by membership, hallelujah, but it is through the baptism of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
As Brother Branham always quoting the verse, for by one spirit we are all baptized into that body.
Right.
Hallelujah. You must be born, not to be a member of that body,
that's
but
right.
to be born.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And by the baptism of the Holy Ghost.
Right.
And Brother Branham said, once we are baptized into that body and became a part of that body, he says that we are not on a picnic. And we are on a battleground.
Amen. That's right. Amen.
Hallelujah. So, in the denominations, their ministers are teaching them that, oh, when you became Christian, your life would be easy, full of blessing, no problem.
Yeah.
But Brother Branham said, you are on a battleground.
Amen. That's right. Amen.
Hallelujah. Once you separate from Satan, Satan became your enemy.
Uh-huh.
And 24/7,
yeah.
Hallelujah, he will use everything,
yeah.
Hallelujah,
right.
Hallelujah,
amen.
Against you.
Amen.
Now, on Israel's journey from Egypt to the promised land, there were three stages. As Brother Abraham said that on our redemption, we also have three stages.
That's right.
From justification,
right.
sanctification, and baptism of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
And justification, when they left Egypt, hallelujah, by believing the word, they separated themselves
right.
from the Egyptians.
Right. Yeah.
And then sanctification, hallelujah, after they crossed Red Sea, hallelujah, and killed all the things behind them.
Right.
Hallelujah. And sanctification through the blood that kills all human desires of evil.
Right.
Hallelujah. Now, as Brother Abraham said, that redemption is in two parts, coming out and going in. But after they come out, hallelujah, God did not let them in right away, but there was a process. God was cleansing them, hallelujah, before God allowed them to get into the promised land,
right,
hallelujah, there were, hallelujah, a period of cleansing,
right.
Hallelujah, sanctification,
amen.
Hallelujah, and then the last stage is when the, hallelujah, the baptism of the Holy Ghost,
right.
Hallelujah, when they crossed Jordan into the
right.
promised land,
right.
Hallelujah, where their inheritance laid, hallelujah,
right.
And we know that Jordan means death.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So now the greatest battle in the time of Israel, hallelujah, was not when they just left Egypt,
right.
The greatest battle that happened in the time of Israel was when they crossed Jordan, after they crossed Jordan.
Amen.
Hallelujah, because they have to fight in every inch of their inheritance.
Right.
And the Bible says that every land that the sole of your foot tread upon,
right.
that land is yours.
Yeah.
But, you know, it is a promise. It is a sure
right.
promise of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. It is really their inheritance.
Uh-huh.
But God did not let them just, give them that land easily, but God put giants, well-trained armies, walled cities, hallelujah. It means to say that they have to fight, hallelujah, in order to get that inheritance. So it is not easy, brothers and sisters, to get that inheritance. Hallelujah. Now, in the natural battle, there must have teamwork.
Amen.
Or else you cannot win any battle without a teamwork.
Right. Amen.
That's why our country, the Philippines, being an ally to the United States, every year they have, we call it in our dialect in Filipino, balikatan exercises. It means that there is a military exercise that they are doing every year to build up a teamwork, you know. Because in case the United States is being attacked or the Philippines is being attacked, hallelujah, they already have that teamwork. They know already what to do. Hallelujah. So they must have a teamwork.
Amen.
That's why when one time I was watching in YouTube this documentary how the American forces invaded Iraq and Afghanistan. They all have this teamwork. They have the ground forces with tanks and the soldiers. They are in full battle gear, hallelujah, bulletproof, and they have the night vision goggles, and then they have ammunitions and high-powered guns. But brothers and sisters, if they will just get into Iraq by that group, they cannot win. So they have the support from the artillery. Hallelujah. They have the support from above, the Air Force. And when they needed, hallelujah, missile, they have the Navy. Hallelujah. To launch a missile, hallelujah, to Iraq. So they could win the war. They could win the battle. They need each other. But above all, as the saying says, he who dominates the air, he wins the battle.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why, brothers and sisters, when you see, I think several millions of soldiers China has.
Yeah.
But the American soldiers, they only have, I think, more than 300,000. But when you see the forces, you know, the power of America, they have a lot of fighter jets.
Right, yeah.
Hallelujah. Because he who dominates the air, hallelujah,
amen,
they win the battle.
Right. Amen.
Without the power from above,
amen,
hallelujah,
amen,
they will not win.
That's right.
Glory.
It's the same thing with our battle.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If we will just rely on our ability, on how righteous we are, we cannot win, brothers and sisters. We need a power from above.
Amen.
Hallelujah. In order,
amen,
to win that battle.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So, now, one thing more, brothers and sisters. When I was a boy, our house was, there was a military camp in our village near to our house. And I noticed these armies that when they don't have operation, sometimes they go to houses and somewhere, some places, and they get drunk. And then they go drinking. And when they get drunk, sometimes they fight together, you know. They have some differences. But when they go to the battle, hallelujah, they forgot all these differences.
Right.
Although he feel upset on his fellow soldier, but when they are on the battlefield,
amen,
he need to support,
amen,
hallelujah,
his
fellow soldier.
Right.
As much as he can also support him.
Amen.
Because if he, when they got to the battlefield and he start killing all those soldiers that he don't like,
right,
hallelujah, they will surely lose that battle.
Right.
So it's the same thing, brothers and sisters.
Amen.
They know who their enemies are.
Right.
Hallelujah. So that's the same thing, brothers and sisters. Sometimes we don't feel good, you know, you feel upset with brothers. We have some differences with brothers and sisters. But brothers and sisters, I can say that we should know who is our enemy.
Right. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And Brother Branham said that, he said that eternal life is living for others.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And on the day of Calvary, he said he was just one man, the perfect man.
Amen.
He gave his life, and He made an example for you. Now, what must we do? Now, the first thing I want to say is Jesus never lived for himself. His life was spent for others. That's eternal life. When you say you go to church and you do good things, that's fine. But when you live your life to yourself, you haven't eternal life. Because eternal life is living for others. Hallelujah. That's why, brothers and sisters, that we that are strong, we then that are strong. It means to say that, hallelujah, our brothers or our sisters is weak. You that is strong, hallelujah, is the one who is to adjust, who is going to bear his infirmity and not to, hallelujah, put him down. Hallelujah. But the question is, how can you bear the infirmity of the weak when you yourself is weak? Yeah. Hallelujah. You should be strong in order to bear the infirmity of the weak. Amen. Hallelujah. And one of the reasons that God had gave us the fivefold ministry is in order for us to not to remain children. Right. Hallelujah. And in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 11, he said, and he gave some apostles, some prophets, and some evangelists, and some pastors and teachers for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ. Now, the word here, perfecting, comes from the word perfect. And the word perfect, it doesn't mean that you don't have any mistake. You don't have any weakness. You don't have any flaw. But the word perfect here is full grown.
Amen. Right.
A matured. Amen. Matured one or adult.
Right. Right.
Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. For the perfecting of the saints. It means to say for in order for the saints to be matured.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And verse 13 it says, till we all come in the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God unto a perfect man.
Amen. Right.
To be adult. Hallelujah.
Amen. Right.
Unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ.
Right.
That we henceforth be no more children tossed to and fro and carried about with every wind of doctrine. Because if you remain children, then children will be tossed to and fro and carried about with every wind of doctrine.
Right.
But if you are matured,
amen,
you are strong.
Right, right.
Hallelujah.
Right.
Now, that's why in Hebrews chapter 5, verse 12, he says, For when for the time ye ought to be teachers, it seems that Apostle Paul was a little bit disappointed with the believers in, hallelujah, on the Hebrews. After all, hallelujah, that he had done, teaching them, hallelujah, training them, praying for them, and then they are still, hallelujah, weak, and children. Ye ought to be teachers, and have need that one teach you again,
right,
hallelujah, which is the first principles of the oracles of God, and are become such as have need of milk,
yes,
and not of strong meat.
Amen. Right.
Hallelujah. Amen. It means you are still children.
Right.
You cannot bear meat. Hallelujah.
Right.
You still need milk.
Right.
Hallelujah. Now, here are some signs of being a babe or being a child. 1 Corinthians chapter 3, from verse 1 to verse 4, it says, and I, brethren, could not speak unto you as unto spiritual, but as unto carnal.
Right.
It means to say, when you are spiritual, hallelujah, you are adult, you are strong. But yet you are still carnal.
Yep.
So I cannot speak unto you. Right. Hallelujah. Being as a spiritual, but as unto carnal, even as unto babes in Christ.
Right.
Now, Paul, he was not doubting the Corinthians of being in Christ. They are already in Christ, but yet still a babe.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I have fed you with milk and not with meat, for hitherto ye are not able to bear it, neither yet now are ye able, for ye are yet carnal. Hallelujah. For whereas there is among you envying and strife and divisions, are ye not carnal and walk as men? For while one saith, I am of Paul, and another, I am of Apollos, are ye not carnal? So all these manifestations are manifestations, all these characters are manifestations of being a babe or being carnal.
So
carnality is being a babe. Hallelujah. A child. That's for children. Carnality. Hallelujah. Hebrews 5:13, for everyone that useth milk is unskillful in the word of righteousness, for he is a babe. So when he is a babe, he is unskillful. So how can you help? How can you be, hallelujah, a pillar? How can you help your brothers when you are unskillful? Imagine, brothers and sisters, if you go to war and you will bring children, bring babies, hallelujah, instead to help, hallelujah, instead to be a support, they became a burden. Hallelujah. So, hallelujah, you need, God is trying, hallelujah, his people to get into maturity. Hallelujah. And then here's another sign of being matured. John chapter 21, verse 18. Verily, verily, I say unto thee, when thou wast young, thou girdest thyself and walkest whither thou wouldest. When you are young. But when thou shalt be old, thou shalt stretch forth thy hands, and another shall gird thee and carry thee whither thou wouldest not. Hallelujah. When a man, it is, our Lord is speaking about these things. He says, when a man is yet young, hallelujah, nobody can teach him. Whatever he wants to do, he will do it. And wherever he wants to go, he will go. Nobody can teach him. But when he is old, hallelujah, he just stretches forth his hand and somebody will gird him. And then somebody will bring him to places where he don't want to go. It is not his decision. It means to say that he is no longer, when a man is yet young, his own will is being done. But when a man is matured, when he is old, it is no longer his will. He is not doing his own will, but somebody's will. When a man learned, hallelujah, to submit himself to his will, and he is no longer doing his own will, that man is a matured one. Hallelujah. I hope you get what I mean. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And one time, Paul, before his conversion, if I can say when he was young, hallelujah, his will is to kill, to arrest believers. Hallelujah. Put them in jail. Hallelujah. Because he was so jealous to his religion. But one day, hallelujah, he met that pillar of fire. One day he was converted. Hallelujah. And his, Hallelujah. One of his accounts says, Galatians 2:20, I am crucified with Christ, nevertheless I live, yet not I, but Christ liveth now in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me. I am no longer the one that is living, but he is now living in me. Hallelujah. When he was converted, hallelujah. Before his conversion, he was a persecutor. After his conversion, he is no longer living by his own. Hallelujah. Then he is now a big support. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To the believers.
Right.
To the weak. Hallelujah.
Amen.
One time, Peter, before the day of Pentecost, he had been with his Lord, and he loved so much. He loved his Lord so much. Hallelujah. Then one day, maybe Jesus was quoting the scripture. Here is what David said. Here is what Isaiah said. Here is the Old Testament said about me. Hallelujah. Because the Bible says he was telling the disciples what he is going to suffer. Hallelujah. Maybe he said that the Son of Man will be delivered into the sons of man. The Son of Man will be, the shepherd will be smitten. Hallelujah. The Son of Man will be killed. In simple thing, I will be killed. Hallelujah. Then Peter. Oh,
yeah.
Oh, no. Over my dead body. Hallelujah. I will not allow it. Imagine, brothers and sisters, Jesus was expounding to them the scripture. This is going to happen. And then Peter, he said, I'm not going to allow it.
Yep.
Hallelujah.
Right.
I'm not allow it to happen.
Right.
Hallelujah. Then what, you know what Jesus said to Peter?
Right.
Get thee behind me, Satan.
Yeah. Right.
Hallelujah. Although he, in his heart, in his carnality, he loved so much the Lord.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. But it is not according to the scripture.
Right. Amen.
And one time when Malco was about to arrest the Lord,
yeah.
Hallelujah, he brought his machete and he really intended to cut the head of Malco. But Malco, hallelujah, escaped and only the ear was cut.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. But one day, hallelujah,
yeah.
Jesus said, Luke chapter 22, verse 31 to 32, and the Lord said, Simon, Simon, behold, Satan hath desired to have you,
yeah.
that he may sift you as wheat.
Yeah.
But I have prayed for thee,
yeah,
that thy faith fail not.
Yeah.
And when thou art converted,
yeah. right.
hallelujah, is strengthen their brethren.
Amen. That's right. Amen.
Now, Peter, you cannot help. No. At this time, you cannot help your brethren.
Yep.
Hallelujah. Just wait, Peter. Although you love me so much, hallelujah. Although you believe me,
yep.
you believe my word, but you cannot help your brethren yet. You cannot strengthen your brethren yet.
Right.
Hallelujah. But when thou art converted,
Amen.
But Peter, after thy conversion,
yep.
and you will not live by your own anymore,
Amen.
Hallelujah, you live by the leading of somebody,
Amen.
That's the time that you can strengthen your brethren.
Amen. Right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
One time, when Israel was right, hallelujah, beside Jordan in Kadesh Barnea. And you know, Jordan is not a big river. It's not a wide river. It's not maybe about this wide, about this building, hallelujah. And they are about to, it's already the promised land on the other side. And then Moses, he sent 12 spies. And one of the two of them were Joshua and Caleb.
Amen.
And then they went to the promised land to search the land. And when they returned, they have the proof, hallelujah,
Amen.
Of the land.
Amen.
Truly, the land is, hallelujah, flowing with milk and honey.
Glory.
Here is the fruit. You know, brothers and sisters, when you buy a grapes this time, just one cluster of grapes, maybe only 1 pound.
Yeah, right.
Hallelujah. But during this time, the time, hallelujah, just one cluster of grapes, there were two people bearing that, hallelujah.
Amen.
It is enough, hallelujah, to believe that the promise of God, that the word of God is true.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then, you know, maybe our pastor here, if he is going to choose one from this church to be a representative into some meetings or some event, maybe he will not. He is going to choose the brother which is more spiritual. Hallelujah. And then, at this time, Moses, in every tribe, he chose one.
Yep.
It means maybe I can see the most elite.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
He is more spiritual. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. Imagine, brothers and sisters, in maybe several thousands, and then from that several thousands, he hundred of thousands, and then he
right.
chose one. I believe, brothers and sisters, that they were not only 2 million that were in that time.
Sure.
Because when they left Egypt, they were 2 million.
Right.
And then the original ones that came out of Egypt, only Joshua and Caleb went into the promised land.
That's right.
Hallelujah. When they went out of Egypt, they were 2 million. And you can imagine, brothers and sisters, they were 40 years in the promised land, in the wilderness. And 32 years ago, me and my wife, we are only two. We were only two. And then after 13 years, we became nine. Hallelujah. So I'm not going to give any figure, you know. Just think about that, brothers and sisters.
Right.
Hallelujah. When they came out of Egypt, they were 2 million. And then when they were they spent 40 years in the wilderness.
Yep. Right.
So how many do you think when they reach Jordan?
Right.
Maybe they already have they already have grandchildren. Hallelujah. You know, brothers and sisters, when you are here in America or in our time, maybe some of the families, hallelujah, they are controlling to have a lot of children because it's hard to support them. But in the wilderness, hallelujah, what is the reason of controlling when God is supplying all of their needs? Hallelujah. Maybe some of them, they got 15 children, 10 children, or maybe 20, hallelujah, and they have now grandchildren. Imagine from 2 million, hallelujah, after 40 years, hallelujah, how many do you think? Hallelujah, I'm just giving, some ideas. And then Moses picked 12 from every tribe, hallelujah, the most elite one. But when they returned, hallelujah, they gave their reports. Yes, the land, hallelujah, is truly, it is flowing with milk and honey. But the problem, hallelujah, the people there, they eat, the inhabitants, hallelujah. They are in great stature. the cities are walled. Hallelujah. They are now giving the report based on what they see, what they feel. Hallelujah. On their five senses, on their carnal, hallelujah, feelings. And what their heart is beating. Hallelujah. Instead of believing, just holding what the Lord said, we are more than able. Hallelujah. They are now giving a report that they based on their carnality. And you know, brothers and sisters, the Bible says that all the people, they cried out against Moses. Hallelujah. And they went and came to Moses and to Aaron and to all the congregation of the children of Israel unto the wilderness of Paran, to Kadesh, and brought back word unto them and unto all the congregation, and showed them the fruit of the land. And they told him and said, we came unto the land whither thou sentest us, and surely it floweth with milk and honey. Hallelujah. And this is the fruit of it. It means to say that we don't, hallelujah. It is a sure promise, you know, sure word. Hallelujah. That we can rely. Hallelujah. Nevertheless, the people be strong that dwell in the land, and the cities are walled and very great. And moreover, we saw the children of Anak there. And the Amalekites dwell in the land of the south, and the Hittites and the Jebusites and the Amorites dwell in the mountains, and the Canaanites dwell by the sea and by the coast of Jordan. And Caleb stilled the people before Moses and said, let us go up at once and possess it, for we are well able to overcome it. But the men that went up with him said, we be not able to go up against the people, for they are strong than we. And they brought up an evil report of the land which they had searched unto the children of Israel, saying, the land through which we have gone to search it is a land that eateth up the inhabitants thereof. And all the people that we saw in it are men of great stature. And there we saw the giants and the sons of Anak, which come of the giants. And we were in our own sight as grasshoppers. And so we were in their sight. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. We were just like grasshoppers comparing to them. Yeah. The question is, who told them that you are just grasshopper, like grasshopper?
Yeah, right.
Hallelujah. They went there to search, being an spies. It means to say that they did not reveal themselves. They did not show themselves to the people there. They went there secretly, and they didn't talk to anybody.
Right.
But yet, their conclusion, we are just grasshoppers.
Yeah, right.
Like grasshoppers, because they are basing, hallelujah, they live not, hallelujah, according to the word, but they live according to their carnality,
right.
To their five senses.
Right.
And you know, brothers and sisters, when they told this story to the whole congregation of Israel, and all the people were fainted, were discouraged. Hallelujah. Imagine, brothers and sisters, Moses was expecting them after 40 years. Hallelujah. Being a Christian, being a believer, they saw the power of God. They saw the pillar of fire. Hallelujah. Within 40 years, there was no feeble among them. Their clothes did not fade.
Nope.
Hallelujah. Their shoes.
Uh-huh.
Hallelujah. We're not worn out.
Yep.
And God did not fail to feed them.
Right.
Every day. When they are thirsty, there is, hallelujah, this rock.
Yep.
Hallelujah. That is flowing with water.
Right.
Hallelujah. To satisfy them, to give them life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And yet, after all those things, still a babe. And instead, hallelujah, of being, hallelujah, a burden bearer, instead of being a support. Hallelujah. Yep. To bear the infirmities of the weak. Because of their carnality, it made the weak more weaker.
Right.
Hallelujah. That's why, brothers and sisters, when they started to spread this negative report, it caused death in the congregation of Israel. So, brothers and sisters, the same thing. When we in the church, don't allow negative things, don't allow negative report to be spread in. Hallelujah. Because it will cause, hallelujah, the weak more weaker.
Amen.
And the result is death.
Yes.
And the Bible says that they chose captains and they decided to return to Egypt. But the Canaanites and the Amalekites discomfited them and they killed them all.
Yes.
Hallelujah. By the edge of the sword.
Right.
Hallelujah. By carnality. Hallelujah. By being, carnality is being a babe.
Right.
But Joshua and Caleb, they said, oh, we are more than able to possess the land.
Amen.
They are just bread unto us.
Yep.
Hallelujah. Why? The 10 spies and Joshua, they saw the same. Hallelujah. The same thing. They saw the same people, the same inhabitants, the same cities, the same land.
Right.
But when they came back, hallelujah, they have different report.
Right.
Because the 10 were basing upon their emotions. But Joshua and Caleb were basing upon the word of God.
Amen. Right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's right.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Now, Joshua chapter 5, verses 2 to 5. At the time the Lord said unto Joshua, make thee sharp knives and circumcise again the children of Israel the second time. And Joshua made sharp knives and circumcised the children of Israel at the hill of the foreskins. And this is the cause why Joshua did circumcise all the people that came out of Egypt that were males, even all the men of war died in the wilderness by the way after they came out of Egypt. Now all the people that came out were circumcised, but all the people that were born in the wilderness by the way as they came forth out of Egypt, then them they had not circumcised. Hallelujah. Now, I believe, brothers and sisters, that God will not put these things here in the Bible without, hallelujah, any significance.
Right. Amen.
And originally, God's commandment or covenant with Abraham was to circumcise every male child after, hallelujah, he was born. 8 days after he was born.
Amen.
All, hallelujah, in thine house,
yep,
all the male child must be circumcised, hallelujah, 8 days after
Amen.
He was born.
Right.
And then, if you will think about these things, brothers and sisters, it says that all the men of war that came out of Egypt, they were all circumcised, but those who were born in the wilderness were not circumcised. Why? Hallelujah. Imagine, brothers and sisters, when they were in Egypt, they were slaves. They have to work, whether they feel to work or they want to work or not want to work, they have to work because they were slaves. They were busy. And yet they have time to circumcise their children. They don't have a prophet there. Hallelujah. Within 400 years, no prophets. And yet they can do the commandments of the Lord to Abraham. And after crossing Jordan, they were no longer slaves. They were not working in order for them to eat. Hallelujah. And yet they don't have time to circumcise their children. Yeah. And one thing more, they have now the prophet that can remind them.
Yeah, yeah.
Hallelujah. The question is why? Hallelujah. You know, brothers and sisters, hallelujah. For us Gentiles, circumcision or not circumcision, whether circumcision or no circumcision, it has nothing to do with our salvation. Because our circumcision is in the heart by the baptism of the Holy Ghost. But you know, brothers and sisters, when an infant, when you circumcise an infant, whether he like it or not, he can do nothing. He is an infant. It is his father's and mother's decision to circumcise him. Hallelujah. But now, God said, Joshua, you make sharp knives. Hallelujah. You cannot let them get into the promised land without circumcising them. Hallelujah. They have to face that sharp knife. It is now it is now their own decision. Whether they have to face that sharp knife or reject that sharp knife. But they cannot get in, hallelujah, and help them to war if they are afraid a small wound. Hallelujah. Before they continue, hallelujah, to have the battle, they must have to face that knife.
Amen.
They must be circumcised.
Amen.
Before they inherit, they possess the land.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And brothers and sisters, hallelujah, our salvation is not in the denomination that if you are born in a Christian family, then you are also a Christian.
No.
Hallelujah. It must be your own decision.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Whether you accept that sharp two-edged sword, hallelujah, or reject it.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And you know, brothers and sisters, it hurts. Hallelujah. Now, I don't know how do you do it here in the States, but in the Philippines, we do it when we were already about 10 or 8, 10 or 12, without any anesthesia. But some of them, they go, those wealthy people, children, they go to the hospital. Hallelujah. But on our time, we do it, hallelujah, with a sharp knife. No anesthesia, just like the way they did in Joshua time. Hallelujah. And after that outer part must be cut. Hallelujah. The outer man must be cut. Hallelujah. Before you can get in, hallelujah, to the promised land. Before you can possess the promised land. Hallelujah. Now, Joshua chapter 1, verses 1 to 9. Now after the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord, it came to pass that the Lord spake unto Joshua, the son of Nun, Moses' minister, saying, Moses, my servant, is dead. Now, therefore, arise, go over this Jordan, thou and all these people, unto the land which I do give to them, even to the children of Israel. Every place that the sole of your foot shall tread upon, that have I given unto you, as I said unto Moses, from the wilderness and this Lebanon, even unto the great river, the river Euphrates, all the land of the Hittites and unto the great sea toward the going down of the sun shall be your coast. There shall not any man be able to stand. There shall not any man be able to stand before thee all the days of thy life, as I was with Moses, so I will be with thee. I will not fail thee nor forsake thee. Then in verse 6 it says, be strong and of a good courage. As I have said this evening, hallelujah, how can you help the weak when you are also weak? Then God is telling Joshua, you must be strong and have a good courage, because you are going to bring these people into the land. You are going to help them. Hallelujah. To possess the land. For unto this people shalt thou divide for an inheritance the land which I swear unto their fathers to give them. Hallelujah. The question is how to be strong. Hallelujah. Verse 7, only be thou strong and very courageous, that thou mayest observe to do according to all the law.
Amen.
That's the way. Hallelujah. In order for him to be strong and very courageous, Amen. Observe according to all the law which Moses my servant commanded thee. Not turn, hallelujah, turn not from the right hand or to the left hand, that thou mayest prosper whithersoever thou goest. What the word says, hallelujah. That's it.
Amen.
Take it.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And you will be prosperous.
Amen.
You will prosper whither, hallelujah, soever thou goest.
Amen.
This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe according to all, hallelujah, that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success.
Amen.
That's the only thing, brothers and sisters. You can be strong, and you can be prosperous, and you can have success. Hallelujah. That's why Abraham always telling us, hallelujah, it's only one word that if disbelieve, hallelujah, it caused all this problem.
Amen.
Hallelujah. If you say gray hair, and I have gray hair now, if you see ambulance or cemetery, hallelujah, there was only one word that if disbelieve. That's why, hallelujah, in the middle of the Bible, Jesus said, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word, every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. And at the last of the Bible, he says, take not, add not, hallelujah. That's why, hallelujah. And the Lord said unto Joshua, meditate therein day and night.
Amen.
Don't turn to the right hand or to the left hand.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Just believe what the word says.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And you will have a good success. You will be prosperous.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Have not I commanded thee? Be strong and have good courage. Be not afraid, neither be thou dismayed. For the Lord thy God is with thee, whithersoever thou goest.
Right.
Hallelujah. Amen. We can say, brothers and sisters, it is our desire to help. Hallelujah. But if he will not go with me, go with us,
right,
you know, our efforts right is no good.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Right.
We can only help if he is,
Amen,
hallelujah,
right,
in us.
Amen.
I will be, for the Lord thy God is with thee, whithersoever thou goest. When? You will not turn to the right hand or to the left hand,
Amen,
and you will do all the commandments of the Lord.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The word of the Lord. Now, hallelujah. Joshua chapter 3, verses 1 to 4. And Joshua rose early in the morning, and they removed from Shittim and came to Jordan, he and all the children of Israel, and lodged there before they passed over. And it came to pass after 3 days that the officers went through the host, and they commanded the people, saying, when ye see the ark of the covenant of the Lord your God, and the priests, the Levites, bearing it, then ye shall remove from your place and go after it.
Right.
Yet there shall be a space between you and it,
yep,
about 2,000 cubits by measure. Come not near unto it, that ye may know the way by which ye must go, for ye have not passed this way heretofore. Now, here is the thing, brothers and sisters. Who is the leader of the time?
Right.
Israel.
Right.
It was Joshua,
Amen,
which is the type of the Holy Spirit.
Right. Amen. Right.
But the actual that were leading them, it was not Joshua in front. It says here, the priest,
uh-huh,
hallelujah,
Amen,
that bear the ark, Amen, bear the word,
right,
hallelujah.
Right.
But it was Joshua the leader,
Amen,
hallelujah. And he gave some apostles, some prophets, and some teachers for that bear the word. Hallelujah. Amen. Don't go near. There must be a space of 2,000 cubits. That's why, brothers and sisters, that if you have a revelation higher than your pastor, I doubt it, brothers and sisters. Yeah, hallelujah. Right. You must have to listen to your pastor.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Although he is just a man, but God is using him.
Amen.
It is the Holy Spirit that leading this church, but he uses a man. Amen. Hallelujah. Although all of us have the Holy Spirit, those are baptized with the Holy Ghost, we have the Holy Spirit, but God is using, hallelujah, this man here.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And don't go near, don't go before him, but there must be a space of, hallelujah. So, 2,000 cubits or 3,000 feet. Hallelujah. Now, verse 14, and it came to pass when the people removed from their tents to pass over Jordan, and the priest bearing the ark of the covenant before the people, and as they that bear the ark were come unto Jordan, and the feet of the priests that bear the ark were dipped in the brim of the water, for Jordan overfloweth all his banks all the time of harvest. That the waters were came down from above, stood and rose up upon an heap very far from the city Adam, that is beside Zaretan. And those that came down toward the sea of the plain, even the salt sea, failed and were cut off. And the people passed over right against Jericho. And the priests that bear the ark of the covenant of the Lord stood firm on dry ground in the midst of Jordan. In the midst. Hallelujah. And all the Israelites passed over on dry ground until all the people were passed clean over Jordan. Now, brothers and sisters, how about if you were the priest at that time? Think of it. And then during the time of harvest, the snow were melting, and the Bible says that the verse that we read is Jordan was flowing, hallelujah, all the time, and the current was strong, hallelujah. And then here are the priests bearing the ark. And then Joshua will tell the priest, okay, priests, go into the middle of the river. Oh my. Maybe you will have to think twice before you will do it. But brothers and sisters, the priests didn't live for their own. They live for the service of the Lord, to serve their brethren. No matter if the water is strong, no matter if they will drown, hallelujah, in the midst of Jordan, they have to do it anyhow.
Amen.
That is their responsibility.
Right.
And they really did it. But the good things, brothers and sisters, when they started walking into Jordan, hallelujah, that the river turned into a dry ground.
Right.
Amen. Hallelujah. So they have to do everything. Hallelujah. Because that is, they have the obligation for their brethren.
Right. Amen.
And imagine, brothers and sisters, when they were in the midst of Jordan. They are carrying that box. And then on top of it, there were two cherubims, gold. And it is not only, you know, a light thing.
Oh, no. That's right.
And one thing more, there were two table of stones inside of that. Hallelujah. Maybe at first, it is just easy, you know. But imagine, they were not only 1,000 people that are going to cross Jordan.
No.
Millions of them. And you have to stand there.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Firm. The Bible says firm.
That's right.
Hallelujah. While Joshua was watching, the Holy Spirit was watching the tribe of Reuben, the tribe of Judah, the tribe of Dan, the tribe of Manasseh, the tribe of Ephraim, the tribe of Issachar, of Zebulun, and Gad, and Benjamin. Hallelujah. They are not just, you know, it will not just take an hour. Hallelujah. But the Bible says they have to bear the ark and stand there firm. Maybe if you will look to those priests, they have a good, you know, they are good looking with a nice robe, pure linen, white, hallelujah, with, you know, some designs, hallelujah. But the thing that you don't know, that they don't know, they have a knees, hallelujah, inside that robe that were shaking, hallelujah. Just, hallelujah, they have to endure.
Amen. Right.
Hallelujah. The burden just for their brethren.
Amen.
To pass over.
Amen.
Jordan.
Right.
And beside those millions, they have, the Bible says, they have a lot of cattle with them.
Right. Yep.
Hallelujah. Sometimes, you know, brothers and sisters, I like to be minister. Because, you know,
yeah.
Especially in the Philippines, that there are some believers, they go to church. Some of them just wearing slippers. And then here are the pastors wearing a long sleeve and tie. But that's the only thing that some people see. But they don't see what's the burden that's
right.
in their heart. You know, you have to understand your pastor. You have to understand the ministers. Hallelujah. He is also a human being. If you have weakness, he also have weakness.
Right.
If you have needs, the pastors also have needs, and you have to pray for him.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Not only look, he is driving a nice truck, a nice vehicle, but brothers and sisters, inside of that, hallelujah, good-looking pastor.
Right.
Hallelujah. You have to understand the burden that is in his heart. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And Revelation 5:10, it says, "And has made us unto our God kings and priests, and we shall reign on the earth."
Amen.
Priest is to bear burdens.
Amen.
But brothers and sisters, this time it is no longer the priest only. But Abraham said, hallelujah, and he has made us kings and priests. And we are a royal priesthood. Every one of us. Abraham said, kings and priests, plural. Every son and daughter of God, you have now, he made you kings and priests. And you have the obligation. Hallelujah. Not to live for your own, but to live, hallelujah, for others. Because eternity is living for others. Hallelujah. Now, I'm just trying to make this to hurry. Last verse that I'm going to read, Deuteronomy chapter 3, 18 to 20. "And I commanded you at that time, saying, the Lord your God hath given you this land to possess it. Ye shall pass over armed before your brethren, the children of Israel, all that are meet for the war. But your wives and your little ones, and," hallelujah, "and your cattle, for I know that ye have much cattle, shall abide in your cities, which I have given you, until the Lord have given rest unto your brethren as well as unto you, and until they also possess the land which the Lord your God hath given them beyond Jordan. And then shall ye return every man unto his position which I have given you." Now, "and he has made us kings and priests." Hallelujah. Abraham, I repeat, Abraham said, plural, priests. Every son and daughter of God, He made you a priest. Hallelujah. And the verse that we read, 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 5, ye also as lively stones are built up a spiritual house and holy priesthood to offer up spiritual sacrifices acceptable by Jesus Christ. Amen. If God made you, hallelujah, a priest, then for what purpose? We are a holy priesthood, is to offer up spiritual sacrifices. When we say sacrifice, when you feel that you don't like to do it, it's the time for you to sacrifice. If you want to do it, that is not sacrifice because you like it. Hallelujah. But if you, it seems it's contrary to your, you know, that's the time that you have to sacrifice. And that's a little the duty, the obligation of a priest. And Brother Abraham said, if you don't feel to come to church, if you feel to come to church and you like it, hallelujah, that's not sacrifice. Nope. But when you say, oh, I don't want to go to church, I'm tired. That's the time that you have to sacrifice. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. When your brother have done wrong, hallelujah, to you, and you don't feel good to your brother, to your sister, brothers and sisters, that's the time that you have to sacrifice. If he did wrong, it is his infirmity, it is his weakness, it is her weakness. And you are thinking that you are strong. The Bible says, you that are strong then ought to bear the infirmities of the weak. Hallelujah. You live not for your own. If you live for your own, if you come to church and do good things, that's fine. But if you live your life for your own, that's not eternal life. Because eternal life is living for, hallelujah, others. Living for, hallelujah, to make sacrifices, hallelujah, for those that are weak. Hallelujah. So the verse in Deuteronomy that we read is, God said, when they possess the land, they do not possess it. They didn't possess it just one time, you know. No. They have to fight every inch. Amen. And then after fighting this area, okay, Reuben, this is now yours. Then they have to fight again. Okay, Judah, this is now your inheritance. But those who first possess the land, hallelujah, they have to pass, hallelujah, over. They have to fight, hallelujah. They still have to fight.
Yep, that's right.
But not for their inheritance anymore because they already had possessed the inheritance.
Right.
They have still to fight, but not for their own. They have to fight for their brethren.
Right,
hallelujah. What is our inheritance? What is our position? Is our lives in the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
You became first, you became the first one to get matured. And then those who get matured, the first who get matured, you have to fight, hallelujah, you have to help for your brethren so that they can possess, hallelujah, to their inheritance.
Yes.
Until all, hallelujah, we have, because God will not, hallelujah, rapture the church unless all, hallelujah, His children can possess their inheritance. We have to, we have to labor every day. Hallelujah. We have to bear the burdens. Hallelujah. We have to help. Although we already have possessed those who are already strong, those who already first possessed their inheritance, then they still have to labor, hallelujah, to understand, hallelujah, the weak, hallelujah. So I'm sorry, brothers and sisters, for my English. I hope you get something from what I have shared this evening. God bless you all, and I'll give the time to our pastor.
Amen. You enjoy the message?
Amen.
Let's stand together. Come on, musicians. Think about it. A promised land.
Yep.
But we got to take it.
Yep. That's right.
Never was this given, stowed away. We got to take it.
Amen. Right.
You know what that does? You ever thought about that? You fight for something. You want it. You want to keep it. You honor it more. It's just stowed down and give to you. You don't care about fighting.
Right.
When you got to fight, hold on.
Amen. That's right.
You love it then, don't
Amen.
You? Amen. Amen. Let's stand together. What we got, brother?
142. Jesus, light of the world, amen.
Anybody have a need? The altar's
Holy
open.
Saints,
you just come and get your inheritance. Jesus, the light of the world. Anybody else have a name? Shine all around us by day and by night. Jesus, the light of the world. The Savior's earth is home. Jesus, the light. Rise up and take what's yours. Walk in the light, beautiful light. Where the dew drops shine all around us by day and night. Anybody else that just have a need? See, with all of the ones that are sick and everything among us, in order to make us all draw together to pray for each other, rise up, take our possession, move into the land and let it all go. Don't worry. Jesus, the light of the world. We'll walk in the light, beautiful light. Come where the dew drops are mercy. How about it? Anybody have a need? Jesus, the light of the world. Not him in today. Jesus, the light of the world. Come and see if he lives. Jesus, the light of the world. Anybody else? We'll walk in the light. Beautiful light. Come where the dew drops of mercy. Shine all around us by day and by night. Jesus, the light of Just think about it. What a day and an hour that we're living. I think this way all the time. I think, Lord, there's a lot of promises you made. You know, the prophet said he don't remind, bother him to remind him of what he promised to us. He wants us to do that. Well, have you ever thought about it? Lord, you promised us. There's no need to worry about time and life, and because he promised the bride would be overcomers.
Amen. That's right.
He promised an outpouring of the Spirit to take care of all things.
Amen.
He promised all kind of things to us. All we got to do is accept it.
That's right.
Amen. Tell our brother how much you appreciate it. We appreciate him coming, being with us and everything. He's going to be traveling on tomorrow and ministering and all. Just pray that the Lord would bless him, take care of him, and all. As I always say to you when you were here and we have company, if you have anything you'd like to give to the brother to help him along the way, feel free to do. Because that's just part of it. Because we're all in the body of Christ, serving the Lord and walking in the light of his love. Amen. Remember to pray for Wade and him traveling this weekend, Brother Luis. You know, just remember these that are out doing their part for the Lord. All right? All minds clear?
Amen.
Let's just pray. Father, we thank you for the day and the word that we've heard. We thank you that our brother has poured out his heart unto us to express what he thinks of you. And Lord, now it's laid into our hands to what we think. So let us think about the things, Lord, that you promised. You said you'd do these things, so we believe it. They're just as much a promise to us to today as it was a promise one day that the Holy Ghost would come, that it would do all the things it would do. Now we're here in a manifestation of all of those things. And we ask you, Lord, to just be with each and every one of us. Bless our brother as he travels on the way tomorrow and just give him a safe journey. Oh, Lord, and bless everybody going home tonight. Take care of him. Lord, be with all the sick among us because you promised to heal us and deliver us from destruction. So we just remind you of what you said. And we thank you then for it. We love you, and we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.